Hello, and welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast. I'm your host, Karma Spence, the Genre Traveler. Today, I'm chatting with Gabrielle Faust, best known as the author of the post-apocalyptic techno-horror vampire series Eternal Vigilance. She is also an illustrator and entertainment critic. She is currently at work on the fourth Eternal Vigilance novel, as well as the sequel to Regret. Welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast, Gabrielle.
Well, thank you so much for having me on today. I did have one reviewer one time call it Interview with the Vampire Meets the Matrix. So you have this futuristic, gritty world where technology is dominant. There's a breakdown of societies. There's a breakdown of communication between, you know, the Taist Empire, which is like a dictatorship, and then the fragmented remains of the rebel uprising and the vampires who are still struggling to survive. And then you interlay that with a lot of very deep, rich, metaphysical musings and, you know, interpersonal relationships between the vampires and the humans and their struggle for survival. So it does cross genres. I tend to do that a lot with my work. I don't like being confined to pure horror or pure science fiction or pure dark fantasy. I like to bring in as many aspects as possible from all the genres that I like, because realistically, it just suits the topics that I write about a lot better. It was supposed to be just one book, and now we're going into the fourth book, and there's actually six total planned for it, because it's just, this world is just it's just evolving constantly, and I think there's a lot more of the story, a lot more of the philosophical and the metaphysical musings that I want to tap into over the next few books. Well, the entire Taist Empire is plugged into this, what has become. Over time, it evolved, and it actually becomes sentient. It's an artificial intelligence mainframe grid it's a biotechnology that has become sentient, and basically the entire world is running off of this mainframe, this one power source. And through his interaction with it, Tynan becomes aware of the fact that it is beginning to live independently of the Taist Empire. And gradually over time, the Kronos, which is what the technology is called, the Kronos will basically not even need its human keepers anymore.